Yan. So, good morning, everybody. And good morning, Grade 9 Leo. Yan. So, unfortunately, we'll not be able to have a proper meeting, you know, just like what we used to be. But, of course, I'm just actually playing this video recorded so that you'll be able to know what is our last topic on this third grading. So, remember, class, last meeting, we can't be able to, or we didn't able to meet each other because of the different reasons, most especially because of the happenings inside the school, okay, because we're actually preparing for the face-to-face or limited face-to-face, so that we are very busy. Okay, I'm apologizing for that one, but of course, and so we're not going to stop what we are discussing. And in our last topic, we are going to talk all about the constellation, but before that, okay, so let us pray first. Let us bow our head and close our eyes and feel the presence of the Lord. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Almighty and ever-living God, as we begin our class today, we give you praise and thanks for everything we have, for everything we do, and for everything we will partake. We ask your guidance, your protection, and your grace as we continue with our journey today. May your divine light guide our path, and your loving arms hold ours so that we may be led to the path you have designed for us. Make us more resilient in difficult times like this, and make us stronger so that we will have the courage to face the future with confidence. We are thankful for this grace of being able to study despite of this pandemic, and that we also pray for those who are less fortunate, who cannot make it for whatever reason may it be, this school year because of this pandemic. We pray, O Lord, heal those who are sick, bless the frontliners, and protect us from this disease. Our family, our friends, our classmates, our teachers, and all who have entrusted themselves for your protection. This we ask in your most holy name. Amen.
And in the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, so once again, everybody, and good morning. Yan, salamat sa tatlong sumagot. Once again, good morning. Okay, so once again, looking back to our topic last, looking back to our topic, okay, the one that we are talking about a while ago. So, yan. I'll wait for a minute. Yan. So, let me share it to you my screen once again. Our topic for today is all about, okay, constellation. Okay, so quarter 3, week number 8. Okay, so I know that you are familiar with constellation, and I know that some of you are very interested when it comes to different constellations in the Earth. Okay, so remember, class, whenever we say constellation, ano ang ibig sabihin? Okay, paano nga ba tayo o ano nga bang epekto ng pagkakaroon ng constellation natin? At ano-ano nga ba yung nabubuo natin by means of constellations? Okay, so if I'm gonna ask you a question, class, for you, what are the words that refers to constellation? Anything that connects to the word constellation, okay, you can actually use your chat box for me to answer or for me to read your answer in my question. Once again, the question is, whenever you hear the word constellation, what are the things that comes to your mind? Or what are the words that you think that connects from the word constellations? Once again, all you have to do is to comment your answer in the comment section. Yan. Okay, so for that, for me to read your answers. Okay. Okay, di ba? Lagi natin pag na ano, pag kapag naririnig natin. Actually, during our grade 9, during our grade 8, 7, and so on and so forth. Okay, lagi nating naririnig ang consolation. But what actually a consolation? No? Oops. Okay, so I think there is something na nasagot. Okay. So okay, so whenever we hear the word consolation, so we actually, you know, we think different words or different things whenever we say consolation. So of course, for me as a student and for me as a teacher, or for you as a student and a teacher, so I know that some of you are very you know, very familiar when it comes to consolation. But whenever we say consolation, again in our quarter 3, some of you thinking all about the stars, about the universe, ayan. So those are actually the words which connect to the consolation. Okay, in our quarter 3 week number 8, this is our learning competency. We have to show which constellation may be observed at different times of the year. So remember, class, now whenever we are seeing, whenever we are put our heads up, okay, we see different stars. Okay, at lagi nating nakikita at lagi nating na pinaniniwalaan ng bata pa lang tayo na whenever we hear or whenever we see a stars, automatically nagpe-pray tayo. Okay, at dito malalaman natin ngayong araw na ito kung ano nga ba o yung mga paniniwala dito sa mga stars na nakita natin above us. Okay, so we're not going to play the jumbled letter because when I converted the PPT into the G-slide, ito yung lumabas. Kapag ginagalaw ko siya, yan. So, nagkakaroon na error. Okay, bawi tayo next time about the game. Okay, ang game lang naman ito is all about the universe, all about the stars. We have to rearrange the following letters so that we'll be able to know and we'll be able to get the hidden words dito sa ano natin. Okay, so for example, itong kanina, ang letters ay STRI. Then the question is, or the definition is, an astronomical object consisting of luminous spheroid or plasma held together by its own gravity. So the answer is stars. Okay, so tatanungin na natin, ha? Okay, pero anyway, sige, tatanungin na natin. Yan, so once again, whenever we say star, it's any massive self-luminous celestial body of a gas. In massive self-luminous celestial body of a gas that shines by radiation derived from its internal energy. So in this picture, class, you can see that there is a combination, or there is there you can see the different sizes of different stars. In the solar system, yung pinakamalapit na na star sa ating solar system ay wala iba kundi ang sun. You know, if we're going to compare the size of the stars with the sun, makikita natin na parang gatuldok lang talaga ang sun. At kung i-compare natin yung Earth dun sa sun, eh talagang napakaliit lang natin. So just imagine that. Whenever we say star, it's considered as a luminous object. When we say luminous, they can be able to produce their own light, and that light will travel in the universe by means of the radiation. Okay, so for example of the stars here, you can see the Betelgeuse, the Antares. We also hear the Rigel, the white one, and then yung pinakamaliit dyan, which is the sun. Okay, just imagine how big that one. Okay. So, lipat natin yung ano natin. So, as you can see, class, lipatan natin. And itan natin para makita natin. Okay, so star color ranges from red to blue. The color of the star indicates its surface temperature. The table below shows the surface temperature and color of different nearby stars, including the sun. Okay, in this table, you can see the name of the star, the color and the surface temperature in Celsius. Okay, when I am young, lagi akong tumitingin sa ano kalangitan kasi lagi kapag sinasabi sa GMA 7 na magkakaroon ng shooting star, lagi kong I feel very interested and I feel very excited and interested when it comes to the shooting star. So that's why pumunta ako sa bubong namin or sa labas ng tindahan namin, tapos kahit hanggang alas 2 nakatingin lang ako sa ano, sa kalangitan. Okay, and there I observed that there's a lot of color when it comes to star color. Okay, ano nga ba yung pinaka mga kulay na nakikita natin sa bituin? Ano yung mga kulay? So we have there of course the obvious one, the white one. We also have the red one. We also have the blue one, the orange one. Yan. So we have a lot of colors of stars. That did you know, class, that based on their color, we can be able to identify whether the temperature of that star is very hot or on the standard form of what is so-called the cold one. Okay, tandaan natin, class, na kapag ang pinakamainit na kulay ay hindi red, no? The hottest color is blue. And then, yung pinaka-cold one, that is the red one. No? Ibig sabihin, pag nakikita ka ng bituin na kulay blue, automatically, it's very hot. Okay, so, in this table, we can see the star, the sun, which have the color of yellow, and its temperature in degrees Celsius is 5,700. Another is the Proxima Centauri, or Centauri. The color of this star is red, and then its temperature in Celsius is 2,300. Okay, the next one, the Epsilon Eridani. Okay, ang kulay nito ay orange. At ang degree Celsius nito ay 4,600. The next one is the Vega. The color of the Vega is white. And its surface temperature reaches 9,900. The next one is the Sirius. The color of this one is white. And its temperature goes to 10,000. And then the last one is the Alnilam, which is color blue, yung pinakamainit na sinasabi ko kanina. And then its temperature reaches 27,000. So if you're going to compare the temperature of the sun with the Alnilam, wala pa sa kalahati yung temperature, no? Kumbaga sa atin, parang sa atin, pag binabalak niyong pumunta sa sun, hindi ka pa nakakalapit, tunaw ka na. O, dito pa lang, kung i-compare natin yan sa Alnilam, kung saan meron itong napakainit na temperatura. So, you know, it's very difficult for us to imagine kung gaano kainit itong mga stars na ito. Okay. So, in identifying the star, we actually have the two types of brightness. Okay. The number one is the apparent brightness. Number two naman is yung tinatawag na absolute brightness. Whenever we say apparent brightness, this is the star brightness as seen from the Earth. So, for example, here in the Earth, we as a human, whenever we observe the stars, nakikita natin na ito ay maliwanag kapag talagang maliwanag, as in. Ngayon, nakikita natin may mga bituin na hindi na natin naaaninag na sa sobrang layo na nila, napakaliliit na ng kanilang mga itsura. Okay, so pag sinabi natin apparent brightness, that is the brightness that we can see in the Earth, dito sa mundo natin. Okay, however, whenever we say absolute brightness, ito naman yung brightness na ayun talaga yung brightness kung ano talaga as is. For example, kinuha mo yung napakalayong bituin na yun papunta dun sa kalayo ng bituin na malapit sa Earth. So pag kinumpare mo yung dalawa, ayun yung tinatawag na absolute brightness. Kung ano talaga yung pinaka brightness nila sa totoong sila. Kasi 'di ba, yung ibang bituin, hindi na sila nagmumukhang malaki at nagmumukhang mataas ang brightness because of their location in the Earth. Kasi nga malalayo sila. Kaya tuloy, ang nangyayari, eto, malayo na din at unti na lang yung ilaw na, okay, yung ilaw na kanilang napuproduce at nakakaabot dun sa Earth. Okay, so, a constellation, by the way, is a pattern or a shape made by stars in the night sky. As you can see, no, if you are going to visit the NASA and if you're going to search in the Google the constellation, you will find a lot of constellation in the universe. Okay, tayo, kung i-compare tayo dyan, tayo lamang ay napakaliit na alikabok. Na just imagine, we in the Earth, para lang tayong alikabok, pero may buhay. So, hindi mawawala sa isipan natin na someday, somehow, eh, makatagpo tayo ng star or the planets na meron ding mga buhay. Yan. At kapag nangyari yun, malamang wala na tayo kasi nga, that's in the future. Malay mo naman, no? Pag kayo ay lumaki na, or pag kayo ay nagkaedad din, eh, na maabutan nyo yung pagkaka-discovery natin sa mga planets sa may buhay. Okay. So, constellations are... constellations can have the patterns of the animal, mythological creature, the man, the woman, the inanimate objects. Pag sinabi inanimate object, yung mga bagay. Just like, for example, the microscope, the compass, and the crown. So, yung mga sinuunang tao, naniniwala sila na ginagabayan sila ng mga bituin. Di ba may mga comics pa nga tayo or mga animation na kapag namatay yung isang tao, nagiging bituin. So, those are what we so call the belief and the pseudoscience nung mga unang panahon. At yung mga bagay na to at yung mga pinaniniwalaan nila dito ay hanggang ngayon ay pinaniniwalaan pa rin natin. Later on, we're going to find out what are those. So, how many constellations are there? We actually have 88 major constellations named by early astronomers. For example, of that one is the North Star. In Polaris, kabilang yan sa mga deeper. So, it's almost directly over the North Pole. So, ito daw yung star na makikita natin directly sa North Pole. Okay, so yung mga constellations na yan, mamaya magbibigay tayo ng different examples of those constellations. Okay, but let's watch this video first. It's let's travel in the world. In the world. Okay, so now let's travel in the universe. Thank you. Ayan, no? Nakita natin kung paano o kung gaano karami kung ikukumpara natin yung ating Earth. Okay, sa milyong-milyon or should I say trillion-trillion mga stars and planets na meron tayo sa universe. Okay, so, but in the Earth class, we actually categorize them into 88 major constellations. And the 13 of them or 13 of those constellations are this. The 13 zodiac constellation. Constellation located within a band. So, pag sinabi natin within the band, yun yung sakop ng 20 degree wide in the sky. If you are living in the tropical country, just like in the Philippines, you can observe different constellations in the that nears in the Earth. But if you are on the North Pole or South Pole country, so kung ano na yung nakikita mo doon sa may taas mismo ng iyong ulo o taas mismo ng lugar kung saan ka nakatira, so yun lang yung ma-observe mong constellations. So, but in the Philippines, since we are in a tropical country, we can observe different constellations. Okay, so we know already, class, that we have 12 zodiac constellations. But of course, here I give 13 zodiac constellations. So, bakit kaya naging 13? At bakit naging 12 yung kinuha natin? That is because we only have 12 months. But here, we can see we have 13 constellations. For example, number 1, we have the Capricornus, yung mga Capricorn, the Aquarius, the Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini. We also have Sagittarius or Sagittarius, the Scorpius, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, and the last one, which is the Orpicus. So, these are the 13 zodiac constellation. Oh, these are the examples of the 88 constellations in total that we have. Okay. So, once again, repeat after me. After I read this, the word, you have to follow. Everybody. Capricornus. Okay, next. Aquarius. Okay, next one, Pisces. Okay, next one, Aries. Okay, next one is Taurus. Okay, the next one, it's Gemini. It's not Gemini, ha? Gemini. Okay, next one, Sagittarius. Next one, Scorpius. Okay, next one, Cancer. Okay, your section, Leo. It's not Leo, it's Leo. Virgo. Libra. And the last one, Orpicus. Okay, that's good. Once again, these are the 13 zodiac constellations in total of 88. Okay, so next one is this one. Whenever we say circumpolar constellation, meaning to say, the constellations that appear to me because of Earth is moving, or because the Earth is actually moving. If we're going to observe day by day the stars, okay, it tend to be moving, but it's not actually moving in its location. That it tends to be moving, that is because the Earth is actually moving. Hindi tayo, hindi ang stars at hindi ang constellation ang gumagalaw, but tayong nasa Earth ang gumagalaw. So, para silang gumagalaw at nag-iiba, depending on the month that we have, okay, depende rin yan sa location na nakikita natin sa kanila. The only star na hindi nag-iikot o hindi gumagalaw, parang hindi gumagalaw, is the Polaris o yung tinatawag natin in the North Star. Bakit? Kasi nga, siya ay nandun lang sa pinakaibabaw talaga ng North Pole. So, siya yung pinakamalaking star na malapit dun at yun yung nakikita natin. Ibig sabihin, sa kapaligiran niya, lahat ng star and constellation na nakapaligid sa kanya ay gumagalaw, but siya hindi. Some constellations can only be seen in a certain season, depending on the month that you have. Okay, so for example, ang Orion, hindi daw nakikita ang Orion kapag summer, that is because it faces in the northern hemisphere of the Earth. So, May mga constellations din mamaya na magiging example natin na nakikita lang sa specific month na iyon. Okay, now let's continue. Okay, so for example, here, this is the northern hemisphere. The other one is the southern hemisphere. If you're going to compare the two, okay, some of the constellations here in the northern hemisphere cannot be seen in the southern hemisphere. Just also in the southern hemisphere, some of the constellation here we cannot be able to see in the northern hemisphere. That is because depending on the month and depending on the location of the Earth, okay, that would depend what kind of constellation will be seen. Okay, let's take a look at some constellation. Kanina pinakita ko sa inyo yung 13, pinangalanan natin yung 13 zodiac constellations. Okay, now let's try kung ma-identify nyo yung mga constellations na nandito. Okay, so for example, yung kanina ginawa natin example si Orion. The large constellation Orion, ang ibig sabihin daw ay ito ay Hunter, and it's prominent or is prominent in the night sky all over the world during winter. So, ito daw ay prominent, ibig sabihin nakikita daw during winter. Nakikita ito sa buong mundo. In the Philippines, yung Orion daw ay, in Tagalog, siya daw ay tinatawag na balatik. Yung balatik, ito ay trap ng mga wild pig. Yung hawak-hawak ni Orion, the hunter. Okay, so, Christian Filipinos named the three stars. Yung three stars na yan, class, ito. Oh. Alam ko nakita nyo na to sa, ano, sa kalangitan. Yung magkakasunod na tatlong bituin. Yan, ito. So, they are what we so-called the stars or the Orion's belt. O yung tinatawag na tatlong Maria or Tres Maria. Okay, di ba nakikita nyo to sa, ano, sa kalangitan, no? Yung tatlong magkakasunod na bituin. They are what we so-called the stars, three stars or Orion's belt, or tatlong Maria, or tres Maria. Yan. If you're going to figure out what are those stars, punta lang kayo dun sa labas, mamayang gabi, at tignan nyo kung asan dun yung Orion's Belt o yung Orion the Hunter. Okay, the next one is the Big Dipper and the Little Dipper. Okay, we have a lot of stories of Big Dipper tsaka si, ano, si Little Dipper. Yan. Pwede nyo i-search kung ano yung kwento niya ni Mama Bear at ni Baby Bear. Okay, anyway, so you have the Google. Okay, search nyo na lang. Okay, as you can see, in the Big Dipper, we have Merak at saka si Dube. They are pointing toward Polaris, yung buntot ni Little Dipper. Okay, in the Big Dipper, it, ayan, sabi niya, pointed stars because they seem to point to Polaris. Another constellations do we have. Okay, next one, ito yung Polaris. Polaris, commonly known as the North Star, is the brightest star in the constellation Ursa Minor, o yung tinatawag na Little Dipper. It is very close to the North Celestial Pole, making it the current Northern Pole star. Polaris stands almost motionless in the sky, and all the stars of the Northern sky appear to rotate around it. Yan yung sinasabi ko sa inyo kanina pa. Siya yung pinaka-brightest at the same time, parang hindi siya yung gumagalaw. Ayan. So, why some constellations are not seen in a certain months? Bakit nga ba? Yan. The constellation is actually depending on the month of the Earth or what the month of the location you are. And then, what is the pace of that Earth? So, for example, kung halimbawa, ayan ay March na, ang constellation na nag-a-appear ay Boots or Butes, Cancer, Crates, Hydra, Leo, and Virgo. Kapag yan ay pumunta naman ng June, okay, so ito na yung nakikita. We have Sagittarius, Aquila, Cygnus, Hercules, Lyra, Opicus, and Scorpius. Okay, e paano kapag September, ano yung nakikita? So ito yung nakikita. We have the Pegasus, Andromeda, Aquarius, Capricornus, and Pisces. At kapag December naman, ito naman yung nakikita. So, we have the Orion, the Cetus, the Eridanus, the Gemini, the Perseus, the Taurus, and the Canis Major. So, class, as you can see, no, in a different months, we can observe different constellation. That is because of the location and the tilt of the Earth. Depende yan kung saan tayo nakaharap. Okay? Okay, hindi tayo pare-parehas kasi imaginein mo kung ikaw ay nakalocate sa western part ng Earth, edi madilim sa'yo, winter sa'yo, tayo summer kasi nasa eastern tayo. Eh kapag binaliktad naman 'yan, oh, that's the time na sila naman ay tatapat doon sa location na nakalocate tayo last time. Tayo naman ang pupunta sa likod. So that would depend on the location of the Earth. Okay, remember ah, the Earth is rotating. The moon is revolving. The Earth is also, yes, the Earth is also revolving around the sun. That is why iba-iba rin yung nakikita natin. Okay, different star patterns throughout the year. So an observer from Earth will be able to see the stars that are on the night side. The stars on the same side as the sun cannot be seen because sunlight overpowers all the starlight. So we actually observe different we can actually observe here na lagi lang natin nakikita ang mga stars tuwing gabi. Bakit? Kasi bakit sa gabi lang natin? Bakit sa gabi lang natin nakikita ang mga bituin? Ano ang reason? Kasi sa umaga merong okay. Dahil may araw, no? May araw kasi kaya May araw kasi kaya naman ano tayo? Hindi natin nakikita. Na-overpower yung liwanag ng or radiation ng iba't ibang star kahit napaka ano pa yan, kahit napaka kinangpan niyan. Eh mas malapit nga kasi yung star na sun. So therefore, na-overpower niya yung ilaw na pinuproduce sa Earth. Kaya ngayon, hindi natin nakikita tuloy. Okay, ibig sabihin ng stars na yan, ang mga stars natin, hindi sila natutulog, hindi sila nawawala. The reason why they are absent during the day is because of the light which overpower. Okay, that is the reason. Okay, so let's give some examples of the constellation. Okay, as you can see, sabi daw dito, do you see a bull? Okay, bull daw ito. Nakita niyo ba yung bull? Or in Tagalog, ang bull ay toro. Okay, nakita niyo ba? Okay, if you can imagine the toro here or the bull here, oh, that's good. But if you are having trouble identifying the shape of the bull here, oh, well, do not worry, marami tayo. Minsan kasi mga constellation ang hirap. Oh, ganito daw itsura niyan. Yan, oh, 'di ba? That's the bull. How about this one? What form do you see? Ano daw yung form? O ano yung shape na nakikita nyo dito? Ano to? Mukha ba itong ano, inidoro? Oo. Na nakaupo. O, nakaupo sa inidoro. Let's see. This is? Ayan. So, that is a woman sitting in a chair or sitting in a throne. Okay. Very good kayo. O, ito. Paano naman ito? Ano kaya ito? Sabi mo. Sir, ano? Ang hirap naman yan, sir. Puro between niya, puro dots lang nakikita ko dyan. Anyway, kaya niyan. This is what we so called. Yan, that's a Pegasus. Yung kabayong may pakpak. Nakita na ba kayo ng Pegasus sa totoong buhay? Pegasus yan. How about this one? Napakadali lang yan. Kitang-kita natin. Ito yung pinakamadaling shape sa lahat at ma-identify agad natin. Anyone? Okay, that is a Scorpius or a Scorpion. Very good. Okay, next one. How about, do you see a woman daw? Okay, do you see a woman here? Okay, let's see. Yan, that is a woman. O, para siya may wings pa, no? Okay, how early Filipino use constellation? In the early times class, we actually use different formations or the constellation for us to guide in our farm. So, for example, during December to February, ang related agricultural activity na pwede natin gawin ay maglinis ng kapaligiran o maglinis ng farm. Okay, kasi ang makikita mong constellation doon ay si Taurus. Ibig sabihin, pag nakita ka na sa, pag nakita mo na yung constellation ng Taurus sa kalangitan, ibig sabihin, maglinis ka na kasi ito ay December to February na. Preparation na siya sa pagtatanim. In local name or in Tagalog, ang pangalan ni Taurus ay Baha. Okay, paano pag January? sa January daw, start na daw siya ng planning what crops to be planted and how wide is there. So where you are going to plant there, kung what kind of plant do you plan to plant. Okay, or to plant. Okay, so that's January. Ano daw yung Western equivalent name ng consonation na yun? That is Pleiades. At yung kanyang Tagalog term o yung tinatawag na local name ay Pandarawa. Okay, how about February? Sa February, start na daw ng pagtatanim. Oo. So, yan ay, ang constellation na nakita dyan ay si Orion's Belt. That's February. Ang Tagalog term niya ay Balatik. During March naman, okay, ito daw yung pagtatanim na ng rice o ng kanin. Kanin ng, ano ba yun? Bigas, ng mais, at saka ng mga gulay. So, we don't have any Western equivalent, but in Tagalog term, that is what we so-called the Malihe. Okay, April and May. Okay, that's the end of planting season, signifies which harvest, or rich harvest. So, ito na yung nag-harvest na tayo. That is actually in April and May. At ang Tagalog term niyan ay Gibang. In Western equivalent ay Gemini. Okay, next one. During the month of May, we stop planting. Okay, because yan yung activity na ginagawa. Ano kasi yan? May na kasi. Pahinga na. Kumbaga, katapos mo lang yan ng harvest. So, pinapagpahinga mo na yung lupa at pinapayabog mo muna. So, ang kanyang Western equivalent ay Canis Minor. At ang kanyang local name ay Malara. Once again, local name Baha. Western equivalent Taurus. Okay, local name Pandarawa. Western equivalent Pleiades. Local name Balatik. Western equivalent Orion's Belt. Okay, Malihe in Tagalog term, but we don't have an equivalent word in the Western. Gibang in Tagalog. In Western, that is Gemini. Gibang. Ah, very good. Gibang in Tagalog. Malara in Tagalog. In Western equivalent, that is Canis Minor. Okay, so what is the function and what is the usage of the stars in the early times? Number one, constellations help people to recognize stars in the sky. By looking for patterns, the stars and locations can be much easier to spot. Okay, so by looking of the patterns daw, we can be able to spot the location of different stars. Okay, so bakit nga ba natin mahalaga o bakit mahalaga na alam natin yung location at saka yung pattern ng star? Because the constellation had used in ancient times as the keep tracker of the calendar. Diba sabi natin kanina, depende sa month. Ngayon, because of that, depending of the month, because of the constellation na nag-a-appear in a specific month, nalalaman kung paanong o kung anong month na ang na kanilang kung kanilang hinaharap. So that is actually very important to people to plant and to harvest. Kasi diba, depende dun sa month na kinabibilangan kung saan sila mag-i-start ng pagtatanim. Number 3, another important use of constellation was navigation. If you are a seaman, or if you are a pirate, or kung ikaw talaga yung manlalakbay, at wala ka talaga, kasi imagine pag nasa gitna ka ng karagatan, so hindi mo makikita, kung sa, wala kang makikita, puro karagatan lang. So ano yung tumutulong sa kanila? That is the stars. They help the navigator what their latitude and ano ba yung kung saan na sila patungo, and that is the help of the star. Okay, so for our references, this one, okay, you can actually watch here or just click this one or copy this one so that you'd be able to watch the video about the constellations. So everybody, class, your LAS for today would be posted at exactly 9 a.m. today. Yan, i-visit nyo na lang yung inyong LAS o yung inyong Facebook group. Nakapost na doon yung LAS na sasagutan nyo. Okay, hanggang ano oras lang yan? Hanggang alas 9 lang po iyan. Hanggang alas 2 lang po iyan. So, maliwanag. Again, makikita nyo iyan ng 9 a.m. Ma-upload yan ng 9 a.m. At pwede nyo nang sagutan yan hanggang 2 p.m. So, please, para hindi na matambakan kasi meron pa akong isang video na i-upload later. Tapusin na yung LAS ngayon. Maliwanag. Madali lang naman yon. Another, do not forget your project tomorrow. Yes, tomorrow na po iyon. Okay, papanoorin niyo po yung live webinar kahit sa Facebook lang. Kung ba, naglalaba ka, naglilinis ng bahay, o i-play mo lang yon. Kasi may attendance yun. At the same time, at the end of the session, they will have the evaluation form that you have to answer so that you'd be able to receive your certificate. Without any evaluation form or without any attendance form, you'd not be able to get your certificate. So please, that is because your project, that is your project for the third grading. Hindi na ako nag-a-ask na another project na gagastos ka. Ito lang yun. Manonood ka lang. Okay? So, maliwanag ba yun? Okay. So, if you don't have any question, please open your camera. We have to take some pictures. Okay. We're not going to take a quiz, ha? Kasi, nasa Baguio ako ngayon. Yes. Recorded lang to. Okay. Everybody, go. Open your camera and give your best smile. Ready? At the count of 1, 2, 3 and smile. Okay, one more time. Ready? Sige, mag-close ka ng camera. Para di makita. Absent ka today pag naka-close yung camera mo. Ready? And 1, 2, 3 and smile. Okay, that's all for today, class. Thank you very much for attending our Zoomit for today. Goodbye, class. Okay, goodbye. Okay, we now end the session. Go. Again, do not forget to answer your LAS that would be posted 9 a.m. later. Okay, goodbye.